Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Okay, sternocleidomastoid muscle. This is an important question in anatomy for in examination view. It is the key muscle of the neck, which extends obliquely across the side of the neck. It is the key muscle of the neck. Which extends obliquely across the side of the neck, divided it into the posterior and anterior triangles. Okay, dividing it into posterior and anterior triangles. Next, origin of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. The muscle arises by two heads, sternal head and clavicular head. We are talking about the origin. Okay. Origin. Sternocleidomastoid muscle arises by two heads. First is sternal and the second head is clavicular head. Okay, next. First, see about the sternal head. Sternal head is tendinous and arises by a rounded tendon from the superolateral part of the front of the manubrium sternum, below the suprasternal notch, and passes up one, back one, and laterally in front of the sternoclavicular joint. See once again, sternal head. Sternal head is tendinous and arises by a rounded tendon from the superolateral part of the front of the manubrium sternum, below the suprasternal notch, and passes up one, backward and laterally in front of the sternoclavicular joint. Next, clavicular head. Clavicular head is flat and musculoaponeurotic. It arises from the medial third of the superior surface of the clavicle. It passes vertically upward deep to the sternal head, with which it unites to form a fusiform belly. See once again the clavicular head. Clavicular head is flat and musculoaponeurotic. It arises from the medial third of the superior surface of the clavicle. It passes vertically upward and deep to the sternal head, with which it unites to form a fusiform head. Coming to the figure. See this figure. This figure shows the sternocleidomastoid muscle origin. Origin of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. See here, sternocleidomastoid muscle has two heads. See, one and two. Okay, what are the two heads? Sternal head, clavicular head. Okay, and the sternal head is tendinous. See, this green one represents the tendinous. Okay, it is a tendinous, and this sternal head arises from the gives origin from manubrium sternum. Okay, and see here, this is the clavicular head. Clavicular head origin from clavicle. Okay, it is a musculoaponeurotic and it is deep to the sternal head. Okay, this clavicular head is deep to the sternal head. Deep to sternal head. Okay, next. See here, some note is given. A small triangular gap exists between the two heads above the sternoclavicular joint. It is called lesser supraclavicular fossa. It contains the terminal part of the internal jugular vein, which may be entered at this site by a needle or catheter. See once again, a small triangular gap exists between the two heads above the sternoclavicular joint. It is called supraclavicular fossa. It contains the terminal part of the internal jugular vein, which may be entered at this side by a needle or catheter. Okay, this is about the note. Next, coming to the insertion of sternocleidomastoid muscle. The muscle is inserted by a A thick tendin, a thick tendon on the lateral surface of the mastoid process extends from its tip of its base, and B, by a thin aponeurosis into the lateral half of the superior nuchal line of the occipital bone. See once again the insertion of sternocleidomastoid muscle. The muscle is inserted by first a thick tendon on the lateral surface of the mastoid process. Very important. Lateral surface of mastoid process extends from its tip to its base. From tip to base. But remember, here is insertion by mastoid process. Next. And by thick aponeurosis into the lateral half of the superior nuchal line of the occipital bone. And the second you have to remember here is superior nuchal line. Lateral half, it's okay, but you have to remember mostly this one, okay, superior nuchal line. That means insertion of sternocleidomastoid. You have to remember the two points or two words, that is mastoid process, first one, and the second one is superior nuchal line. Okay, this is most important here. Next, see this figure. This figure here, it represents the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid. See here, this is the mastoid process. See here, mastoid process. And this is the superior nuchal line. And the line you seen here is the superior nuchal line. And the insertion of sternocleidomastoid is the tip to base of the mastoid process. And the next one is lateral half of the superior nuchal line of occipital bone. See here, this is the occipital bone, everyone knows. And the insertion of sternocleidomastoid is two, okay. And the first one is mastoid process. This is the mastoid process from tip to base. Next, second one is second insertion if sternocleidomastoid is superior nuchal line. See here, this is the superior nuchal line, lateral half of the superior nuchal line. This is about the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Next, arterial supply of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Arterial supply. The sternocleidomastoid is supplied by the branches of the following arteries. The sternocleidomastoid is supplied by the branches of following arteries. Upper part by, first we have to divide the sternocleidomastoid into upper part, middle part, and lower part. Okay, first upper part. Upper part by occipital and posterior auricular arteries, middle part by superior thyroid artery, lower part by suprascapular artery. See once again, upper part by occipital and posterior auricular artery, middle part by superior thyroid artery, and lower part by suprascapular artery. You have for remembrance, see the positions of these. Okay, scapular. Scapula is lower when compared to the thyroid, and the thyroid is in the lower position when compared to the auricles. That means ears. Okay, ears are upper position, thyroid is lower to that, and the scapula is lower to that. That you have to remember for like mnemonic. Okay, next, coming to the note. The knowledge of arterial supply is important to make the muscles clap in reconstructive surgery. The knowledge of the arterial supply is important to make muscle flap in reconstructive surgery. Next, now supply. The sternocleidomastoid muscle is supplied by the spinal accessory nerves. It is also supplied by ventral rami of C2. It is also supplied by the ventral rami of C2 and C3, which are mostly sensory and carry the proprioceptive sensation from the muscle. It is also supplied by the ventral rami of C2 and C3, which are mostly sensory and carry the proprioceptive sensation from the muscle. Next, coming to the actions of the sternocleidomastoid. When muscle contracts, it tilts the head toward the shoulder on the same side and rotates the head to that of the chin, turns to the opposite side. This movement occurs during an upward sideways glance. Understand clearly here, guys. When muscle contracts, that means when sternocleidomastoid muscle contracts, it tilts the head towards the shoulder on the same side. That means, see this also, and rotates the head so that the chin turns to the opposite side. Muscle contracts, head towards same side. Chin turns opposite side. Okay, clear? That means when the left side sternocleidomastoid muscle contracts, head turns to the left side and the chin turns to opposite side. That means to right side. Okay, I show you the figure. You may get the clarity. See the figure? See this figure. If you see this person, for this person, head turns to left side. Okay, head turns to left side and chin turns to right side. Are you able to getting? Okay, that means you have to understand here is same side. We learn that head turns to the same side that muscle contracts. That means the contracted muscle on the left side only. Okay, and the chin turns to opposite side. Okay, the chin turns to opposite side. So left side sternocleidomastoid contracts, that happens here is head turns to the left side, that means on the same side, and chin turns to the opposite side, that means to the right side. Okay guys, next, when muscles of the both side contract together, they drawn the head forward as in lifting the head from the pillow or bending the head toward eating food. If the head is fixed by prevertebral muscle, two sternocleidomastoid muscles act as accessory muscles of respiration during forced inspiration. See once again, when muscles of both sides contract together, they draw the head forward and in lifting the head from the pillow or bending the head toward eating food. If the head is fixed by prevertebral muscle, two sternocleidomastoid muscles act as accessory muscles of respiration during forced inspiration. Okay, I show you the figure. See this figure. This figure shows that both the sternocleidomastoid muscles, that is on left and right side, contract at the same time, which happens that lifting the head forward and downward, it helps during the eating. Okay, and when the two sternocleidomastoid attaches to the prevertebral column, when the two sternocleidomastoid muscles attach to the prevertebral muscles, these sternocleidomastoid muscles act as the accessory muscles for respiration during forced inspiration. Okay, when sternocleido, it occurs only during when sternocleidomastoid muscles attached to the prevertebral muscles. It acts as accessory muscles during forced inspiration. Okay, next relations of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Relations: the sternocleidomastoid is enclosed in the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. It is pierced by the spinal accessory nerve and four sternomastoid arteries. It is superficial and deep. Relations are as under. First, superficial relations: skin, platysma, and three cutaneous nerves. And the three cutaneous nerves are greater auricle, transverse cervical, and medial supraclavicular, lesser occipital. Next, external jugular vein, superficial cervical lymph nodes, and parotid gland. Next, the deep relations of sternocleidomastoid muscles are deep relations in the upper part muscle, posterior belly of digastrium, longissimus capitis, and splenius capitis. Next, artery is occipital artery. We completed the deep relations in upper part. Now the deep relations in the middle part. Okay, first muscles: levator scapulae, scalenus anterior, scalenus medial, scalenus posterior, splenius capitis, inferior belly of the omohyoid. And next, arteries: common carotid artery, internal carotid artery. Next, veins: internal jugular vein, anterior jugular vein. Next, nerves: vagus nerve, spinal accessory nerve, cervical plexus, brachial plexus, upper part of the brachial plexus, and ansa cervicalis, inferior root. And the glands are, and the glands related to middle part of deep relations are thyroid gland and lymphoid nodes. Next, lower part. Okay, next, lower part muscles: sternohyoid, sternothyroid, scalenus anterior. Next, arteries: suprascapular, transverse cervical, and the veins related to lower part of deep relations are anterior jugular vein, and the nerves related to lower part are brachial plexus, that is lower part of the brachial plexus, and phrenic nerve. Coming to the note, the sternocleidomastoid is crossed superficially by the great auricular nerve, external jugular vein, and transverse cervical nerve. In that order, from above downward, on the deepest aspect, it is also related to the deep cervical lymph nodes. This is about the sternocleidomastoid muscle. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.